Here we have illustration 9, and in the question they asked us to do direct method, right? From the following summary cash account of X Limited, prepare the cash flow statement for the year ended 31st March 2011 in accordance with the accounting standard 3 using the direct method. The company does not have any cash equivalents. Okay, so first let's start with the cash flow from operating activities. Right, so first we'll take the receipts. Issue of equity shares, this activities belong to the financing, and then receipts of customers, so operating, so cash receipts from sales, so 2800 we'll write in the operating activity, and then sale of fixed assets, this is investing activity, so there is no operating activities here, and the payment of suppliers, this is operating activities 2000. So cash outflow 2000. Over purchase of fixed assets, this is investing activity. Overhead expenses, operating activity 200 outflow, and then wages and salaries 100 outflow. Cash flow, then there is no other. Taxation is will be deducted from the operations. So, and then dividend is financing activity, because dividend paid, because we are in the payment side, this is payment side, this is receipt side, so this is dividend paid, so it will come under financing activity. If it is dividend received, it will come under the investing activity. Repayment of bank loan, financing activity only, right? So this will be the opening cash and this will be the closing cash. Now, so we are done with cash flow. After doing additions and subtractions, you will get cash flows from operations. For that, if you deduct the tax paid, which is 250, and then you'll get the net cash generated from operations. So let's do from investing activities. So from receipt side, only sale of fixed assets, so write that 100, and then here purchase of fixed assets 200. That's it, we don't have anything here. So net cash generated from the operation is minus 100. So financing activities, so from here issue of equity shares 300, and then in this payment column we have dividend paid 50 and repayment of bank loan 300. Done, and you will get minus 50. So if you do additions and subtractions, you will get net increase in cash and cash equivalent is 100. So 250 minus 100 minus 50, so you will get the 100, right? Now opening cash and cash equivalents, here they are saying 50, so add to that. If you add, you will get 150, which is equal to the closing on cash equivalents. So whatever we did is correct. So see you in the next class for probably 10th question. Yeah, thank you, and do subscribe.